afternoon. My name is Eugene, and I am an engineer in the company Technic LLC. Now we are at our company's commercial dairy farm. This year, we acquired another feeding machine, IRK-01.1, of the Krasnokamsk Machinery and Repair Plant. Currently, our holding uses four IRK-01.1 feeding machines. This machine works without stopping throughout the year. That's 365 days a year. Well, on average, the whole working day, that is 8 to 9 hours a day, the machine calmly withstands the load. This is the operation process of the feeding machine IRK-01.1. The operator drives up to the roll previously laid on the platform by the front lift loader, also of Krasnokamsk Machinery and Repair Plant. Next, the bale is raised again by the feeding machine itself. Further, after laying the bale, it can drive up to absolutely any place, be it either a platform or any uneven place. It can drive into any yard. The overall dimensions of the feeding machine allow us to enter even the lowest building. We did not have any problems with this. For example, upon entering, the operator turns on the PTO shaft of the tractor, and then the automatic equipment does everything required for the tractor driver to perform. A maximum of two people are involved in using this machine. For example, the machine operator himself removes the film on the platform. Then the machine milking operator assembles the mesh. For example, the milkmaids themselves on the case so that the machine operator is not distracted by any further actions. Maintenance and daily maintenance is done by the operator himself. No other people are required to intervene in this matter. Cutting rolls is carried out using the guillotine. The cutting length varies from 3.5 to 15 centimeters. In this case, we use 15 centimeters in our company. This is optimal for animals and speeds up the operating time of the machine itself. The cutting process itself takes the operator from 3 to 4 minutes, no more. In winter, we don't warm the rolls. The feed warms up directly on the feed table. This again does not affect the work of the machine. In winter, there are no complaints about the machine. The main advantage of this technology is that all nutrients remain directly in the hay, in the grass. Weathering does not occur. It is the most optimal nutrition for cows. I think no one has come up with a better idea. For milk, yes, if you used dry hay, milk yield was low. After all enterprises began to use this type of feed preparation, milk production rose, and it became much easier for people to work.